dead after two confirmed tornadoes touched down in the state during Sunday's severe thunderstorms.
And there is extensive damage around the state thanks to straight-line winds. KCCI's Kim St. Ange is live in Oskaloosa this morning where the cleanup is just getting started. Good morning, Kim.
Good morning, Elizabeth. It certainly is. A lot of folks are waking up to tree limbs down in the front lawn, and the folks who work here at the hospital have this to deal with. This is actually Mahaska West, so this is part of the hospital campus here in Oskaloosa, but this particular building houses things like hospice and physical therapy, massage therapy, things like that. So luckily, no one was inside this particular building when this storm tore through Oskaloosa, ripping off this building. Take a look. A lot of damage to this building alone. The roof, like I said, completely blown off, even bending the metal here, blowing tree branches onto it. And the tree branches down in a lot of front lawns as I've been driving around town this morning, those heavy winds also knocked down power lines. In fact, the entire town was without power for several hours yesterday. We have checked with MidAmerican this morning. Right now, as of within the last hour or so, there's still about 100 or so folks here in town without power. So crews will be here in Oskaloosa trying to restore that for those folks. But really the incredible thing is the fact that no one in this entire town was injured. But when we've talked to folks, they say that despite some of the damage they're having to deal with and the cleanup they'll be dealing with this morning, they say they feel very fortunate.
Very fortunate that this is a building that Monday through Friday during the day that would have been severe damage. Today, it's a building.
Okay, so anyone who was working here will actually be relocated to the hospital, so everything is back to business as normal today, of course, except for the folks who were working here, again, who will be in other parts of the hospital here in Oskaloosa. The National Weather Service will also be here in town trying to assess all of this damage. Stephen, Elizabeth.
All right, thank you, Kim St. Ange, live in Oskaloosa for us this morning.
Well, the Keokuk County Sheriff's Office confirms that one person has died in the town of Kinross. That's about 100 miles east of Des Moines. And the National Weather Service confirms that two tornadoes touched down Sunday, one northeast of Mount Vernon and the other north of the town of Floris.
Whole lot of video and pictures coming into our U-Local page at KCCI.com this morning.
Whoa.
You see that? That caused me to pull over. I don't know about you. This is from viewer Matt Doty. He was traveling from Washington, Iowa to Des Moines when he spotted the wind and rain doing some strange things out there. He shot this video near Sigourney. As you saw, the power poles just started bouncing up and down before several finally snapped. The National Weather Service says a possible tornado caused some heavy damage in Ottumwa. They will send a survey team there today to figure out if the damage is from straight-line winds or from a tornado. Winds are estimated in Ottumwa yesterday at 70 miles per hour. We are hearing reports of several people hurt in Ottumwa this morning.